Maya McGuineas with us right now, the Committee for a Responsible Federal Budget. She's the president. Maya, you know, I want to pick up on something I left with Danielle, this idea of whether you buy that June 1st deadline thing. I always feel that whether you agree with that and it's actually later, if it compels you to act to address this, so be it. But I don't see a rush to address this. I could be missing something, but what do you think?
First, I kind of want to take a step back from the June 1st deadline. Like, the point is, this is urgent. They have to get to the table and discuss this and figure out how to lift the debt ceiling without drama. But this has been true for months and months. And waiting to the last minute, this is no way to govern. The fact that this is how we are governing, I think, surfaces a much larger problem that's going on. You can't have a discussion about raising the debt ceiling and putting in place some sensible savings, which is what we should do, without Republicans and Democrats pointing fingers at each other. And there are so many huge issues facing the nation right now. And the fact that we can't govern without it being like two teams blaming each other really bodes poorly for the country. So on the debt ceiling, get to the table immediately. Figure out how to lift the debt ceiling with no drama. It's going to harm us if we even get close. And it's not just about the stock market, right? It's about the signals that we send about whether we're able to govern in a smart way for the overall country. And two, look at the fiscal situation. It's terrible. You and I have been talking about that for years. It's as bad as it's ever been. We're about to be at the record level of debt to GDP. We need to put a sensible package of savings in place. It's time to start compromising.
But chances are we won't. Chances are we won't do that.
So if we don't do that, then you have to lift the debt ceiling without it. I mean, if they don't want to come to some kind of compromise and you need a clean debt ceiling, you cannot default because it is a terrible own goal. I mean, we would harm ourselves. And why do we want to hurt our own country's economy when there's so many things going on around the world that we need to be facing as a single nation?
This other talk, let me ask you about that, Maya. There's other talk out there that we might get our credit downgraded. Maybe in a couple of weeks, if this craziness chicanery goes on, regardless of your political allegiances. And that is, even if we strike a deal soon thereafter, what do you make of that?
Right. When you are a country that borrows as much as we do, which is way too much, we are going to be spending more on interest payments than we do on national defense or Medicaid in the next few years, right? That is just the sign of being stupid in how much you're borrowing, and not for good reasons, just because we don't like to pay the bills. But if you are borrowing that much, being downgraded, having things that increase the cost of your borrowing harm us tremendously. So if interest rates just go up a little because we're fighting inflation or we get downgraded, that leads to huge additional costs in our interest payments, which crowd out other parts of the budget. So again, we are harming ourselves by not acting sensibly and having our lawmakers act as good stewards for the country.
All right. It is a mess, and it's not getting less messy. So we'll have to keep following it. Maya, thank you very, very much.